fellas.
8 o'clock in the morning and there's an audience.
How about, and they're fired up too.
I'm clapping. It's totally rad.
Absolutely. We said Shinedown's going to be performing live in the studio, and we had a throng of people
we
show up.
We gave you a little slapback delay, a little reverb on your
Oh, nice. I don't know what that means, but I like it.
Yeah, it's like the ones and twos, Eddie.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, we got it.
I'm in
got
on
it.
That. Well, welcome to San Diego, boys.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations on all the success you guys have had. And we got a new album coming out pretty soon, right?
Yeah, March 27th.
Amaryllis.
We have to give you total props in the station as well, and all of you, because last week Bully became the number one rock song in America.
Played it this morning.
Thank you guys very, very much.
Yeah.
Awesome. Great song.
Thank you very much.
The tour is going to kick off the same day that the album comes out on the 27th.
Yeah, we have to do Jimmy Kimmel, and then the next day we start Avalanche.
Now, is touring... is it still rock and roll? You know what I mean? Like, you know, we hear all the stories back in the day of, you know, crazy tours and girls and craziness going on. Is that still relevant?
It is. I mean, it depends on, what kind of band you are and what kind of organization you are. When we were younger, it was a little bit crazier than this.
Right.
I mean, the way we look at it is we have one boss, and it happens to be everybody in the audience. So at the end of the day... it basically boils down to the fans. And, you know, going back to the cliches of rock and roll living and stuff like that, hard living can only last for, like, so long. It's
right.
Better to be healthy and have yourself, you know, completely, locked into, knowing what you're doing. As far as, you know, when you're on the road, because we tour on Sound of Madness, the last tour, we toured for 2 years and 7 months.
Oh, my God.
And we did, like, over 440-something shows.
Holy
cow.
So at the end of the day, it's like, you know.
I don't remember your name at the end of the day.
You don't.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, the one thing that I really appreciate about your band is that you guys remind me of old-school rockers. Like, the state of rock and roll right now is kind of weird. It's in a state of flux, I think. And you guys... I believe are bringing it back to the old school days of like real down home rock, and I appreciate that. I think it's great.
Well, thank you. We appreciate that as well. I mean, at the end, it's interesting because in 2011, we're a band that's like the way we look at it is we're really eclectic as far as like the music that we listen to and the music we're influenced by. But at the end of the day, it all comes down to drums, bass, guitar, badass vocals and a great song.
That's it.
So, I mean, for us, I mean, we look at it. In 2011, I noticed there was a lot of pop going on in the United States.
Yes.
And rock has really taken a backseat for the last, like, 2 years. And quite frankly, for me and Zach and the rest of the guys, we just find that to be unacceptable. And I think it's time for rock and roll to have its return and to sit at the head of the table again.
Thank you.
That also takes a community of people, not only in the U.S., but around the world. We just got back from Europe and the U.K. because we wanted to start touring there specifically because we hadn't been back in about 2.5 years since the last record. And, you know, it's alive there. And, you know, it's, in the U.S., you know, I feel it more so in 2012 that rock is going to make its return. It was really cool to see the Foo Fighters win those Grammys the other night.
Yes.
And Dave had a good way of explaining, you know,
right.
What was it he said about the screaming in the microphone, which was kind of cool.
Something about computers will never replace him screaming.
Thank you.
Right.
Amen, brother.
That's true. Right?
Amen.
Yeah. Now, are you ever influenced to maybe try something new because of the trends going on? Like, you know, the Black Keys calling out Nickelback, you know, stuff like that. Like, do you hear stuff going on like that and see what's at the top of the charts and say, hey, maybe we should try this? Or do you just stay true to what you
Honestly, it goes back to the fact that we do consider ourselves to be a really eclectic bunch of guys because we listen to all different styles. But in the studio, we're really fearless. We don't pigeonhole ourselves, and we're also not afraid to try something. Like on Amaryllis, there was a song in particular. It's a song called I'm Not All Right, and there's 5 of the songs on the record that have a 27-piece orchestra.
Oh my gosh, that's rad. I love it.
But on that song, it had the orchestra as well, and at the last minute, Rob Cavallo, who produced Sound of Madness, who also produced Amaryllis with us, we were going to the mix sessions for the record, and at the last minute, he was like, you know what this song needs? Talking about the song I'm Not All Right, and we were like, what does it need? And he was like, let's put a horn section on it. And so we actually we stopped the mix on the song, and we went in to Capitol Studios and we did a 10-piece horn section on it, and it turned the song into this thing that this really, it's an entity into itself because it's not a sound that we've really heard in a long time. Mm-hmm. It kind of reminded me you know, for the younger generation, they might not know it, but it kind of reminded me like when Aerosmith did Love in an Elevator, and how that was like a sound you didn't really hear, because they were doing that. Or like Penny Lane, so, you know, from the Beatles and what have you. But this is, you know, our version of that in a lot of ways. But we're, as far as trends and what have you, we love all kinds of music. We really do. I mean, but in the studio, we're pretty fearless.
You're passionate about music. I can barely get that vibe off you.
Barely.
Well, what do you guys think? Should we hear these guys play some music?
Yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Brent and Zach from Shinedown. What song are you guys playing?
We're going to do one that that's a little familiar first. Hopefully it's familiar. This is called The Sound of Madness.
We hope.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, I get it, you're an outcast. Always under attack, always coming in last. Bringing up the past. Shotgun blast, we're kicking the ass, so paranoid. Watch your back! Oh my, here we go, another loose cannon. Y'all stop holding, get down three, get much lower. Quicksand's got no sense to use it. I'm still having that go. You think that I'm trying to be sorry that you gotta believe in a purple by a social disease. Well, then take your medicine. I created the sound of madness. Gone pain. Somehow I'm still here to explain that the darkest hour never comes in the night. When the dawn, so we're gonna wake up and fall.
That's what I'm talking about right there.
Oh, I
I swear to God, Sky was 2 seconds away from taking her top off.
Oh, I might still. Was that good?
That would be great. I would really appreciate that. And the whole time, by the way, I'm watching Boston Rob Instagramming pictures of
tweeting.
Your... Oh, okay.
Tweeting.
I could have sworn
obnoxious.
You were Instagramming.
Instagramming is next.
I probably should have mentioned this before that performance. We have a webcam. At home. You could have watched that. But maybe the second song? I don't know. Whatever. So go to rock105.com. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a break. When we get back, more with Shinedown when we get back. Make some noise.